quarterbacks have reliable tight ends they know they'll be able to count on to make plays. It's the Chiefs going up against the Rams. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL, the National Football League, is here and on the air. Who said the crowds wouldn't embrace football being back in L.A.? You certainly couldn't tell that by what we saw a few moments ago. These folks are pumped up as their Rams get set to do battle with the Kansas City Chiefs. And welcome again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Larry, he took a moment to highlight the tight ends that we're going to see in this one. I know in our production meeting, we were talking about what we wanted to highlight pregame. And you said tight ends. Why did you say that?
Because it can be such a matchup issue for defenses nowadays. Because these tight ends, they're oversized guys, but they can run as well. So who are you going to cover them with? If you use a traditional linebacker, they're usually going to run past those guys. If you're going to use a smaller corner, maybe they'll be too big. Can a safety match up and run with them and also use enough bulk to keep them from just having their way? So many ways that tight ends are used nowadays, they're fun to watch.
Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And incomplete to open things up.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. On play action, they'll throw. He's going to air one out. And got his man complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 39 that time.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer, that's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, you start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. Now a handoff here to his running back. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
One thing rookies need to learn at this level and quick, make a cut, be decisive, and go. Because in college, you could dance around and wait for a hole to open because you're probably a better athlete than most of the guys on the field, but not on the NFL level.
So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. They'll set up to throw. Now he'll go deep down into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off down at the 10, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Before we see this next possession, you and I were talking before the game about the AFC playoff picture. You got the Pats and the Steelers at 7-2. Those are your best records in that conference. Chiefs at 6-3. Really, they're running away with the AFC West.
Yeah, and that's a surprise, isn't it? Because in preseason, we all, well, I shouldn't say all, but most of us probably thought the AFC West was the toughest division in football. But Denver has fallen off the pace. The Raiders have been a little bit of a disappointment, and the Chargers just can't gain traction. So right now, it's Kansas City's division to lose. And if they get home field, could you imagine all those teams having to visit Kansas City? One of the best atmospheres in the game.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, he'd always say, follow it away, lad, follow it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. They may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Didn't he say laddie or did he say lad?
Yeah, it just depended on what he was feeling at the
okay.
moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about that used to say laddie a lot.
Laddie? When you heard laddie, he's usually in a pretty good mood. Lad?
And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. How about another? And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
He'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A nice gain of 21 yards. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off, because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
And now a first down following that long gain. Now a first carry for their fullback. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
6 yards here to go for the offense on second down.
Let's go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they retain their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So the offense taking over in just a second. But you know, last year, going off the script a little bit, so much talk around Jared Goff, Carson Wentz, who would go one, who would go two, and will they pan out? Well, this year, they are both panning out really well.
They certainly are, and they went 1-2. Jared Goff, number one to the Rams, Wentz, number two to the Eagles. Wentz became the starter as a rookie, played all 16 games, and here in the second season, a lot of MVP talk surrounds him, and rightly so. Jared Goff got left behind, only started 7 games as a rookie, didn't play that well. Many people want to use the B word on him for bust. Not at all. He's playing at a really high level. The Rams are in first place. He might not be in the MVP talk, but how about most improved player in the league?
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
All right, here we go. Green.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Alec Ogletree, not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Partner, I know the ball security is preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to
get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise. They're in the dime.
Hang on now. Boom, landed.
They'll look to throw here. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
On fourth down on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. You know, earlier we discussed Jared Goff's turnaround as we see the Rams offense come back onto the field. But just the Rams in general, coinciding with that Goff turnaround, they're having the turnaround of maybe the NFL this year, aren't they?
They really are, because it's such a, how would you say, such a makeover of the offense. Everyone knew the defense was pretty good and has been for a while, but they couldn't sustain because the offense wasn't giving them anything. Well, this year, they've got 3 wins by 30 or more points. They'd won 3 by that number in their previous 213 games. They scored 40 or more points 3 times this season already. They've done that 3 times in their previous 161 games. That's more than 10 seasons, my friend.
Yeah, the stats are amazing. And just because I didn't say turnaround enough when I teed you up, I just want to say it one more time. What a turnaround for the Rams.
And makeover. If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the side. You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
They'll look to throw now on first down. His throw incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll look to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
All right, here we go. 319.
Now back to throw. And that's incomplete. So possession one ended in 6. Possession two likely going to end in a punt.
Yeah, that's okay. They've just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few adjustments along the way. It won't be exact because the defense will make a few adjustments themselves. Just get back to your game plan.
It's Johnny Hecker now, an all-pro 3 of the last 4 years, on to punt. Back deep for Kansas City, DeAnthony Thomas. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And things haven't started so well for this side. 2 drives, 2 punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done. Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him. And some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will fight his way forward to about the 23-yard line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. So now a 3rd and 7, and defensively, it's a dime look. 6 DBs. To throw here, and that is incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on 3rd down to bring up 4th. Here's Dustin Colquitt now on for his 2nd punt. He'd take a repeat of his 1st. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Taking it about the 16. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a 1st and 10. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion. Put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Let's go. Green 39.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. They'll run it now out of the gun. Slipped 1 tackle, but no more, as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on 3rd down.
Pass situation.
They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a 4th down.
One thing I love about this game is as a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? It's like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
Here's Johnny Hacker now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
So the offense has it first and 10. And they give this time to the tailback. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now out of the gun, a little juke, and he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
They run the counter now on first down. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. And our statistician, Ben Ramsar, just held up 3 fingers to remind me he now has 3 tackles for a loss rolling in the first quarter.
Well, Ben's got it detailed perfectly. He always gives us the right stats. I'd love to be on the offense's headset right now, because what you're hearing is, can someone please block him? Come up with a scheme. Come up with something. Make sure you block him, because he's disrupting everything.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So here we go, first and 10 now. off as they run the counter play. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Here we go now.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. On first down, he'll drop to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go! Boom, landed!
Oh, and now he bowls him. And he's going to bowl his way into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great play there. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Can get settled in here. Time expires on the first quarter of action. 7-7 is the score. We're back to Southern California right after this. Back line. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. They'll drop the throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
They're going to look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Now a handoff here to his running back. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
First down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, 22.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run. Big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Three. They'll run it now out of the gun. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. A nice display of powerful running, but it takes him only to the 7. He's dropped there. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
They definitely established a rhythm on this drive, moving the ball quite well. And big man with football is an integral part of the whole thing.
Looking to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal.
Hey, that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
The fullback try and take him home. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal. Now whistles and a flag down. I think one of the Rams linemen might have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back 5.
Still 2nd down.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Now they'll throw here out of the gun, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
Just looking at from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on, because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position. And they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
And this offense on 3rd down today, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and goal. Back to throw. And it's complete. He's got it. Zone touchdown Rams.
They went 5 wide in that offensive set, and Racing going 3 wide's a big deal. To go 5, how about the way that they finish things off?
Did you just fit a race car reference into the game?
Zoom, zoom. How about the way that you play? When you go 5 wide, that means you're going fast now.
Zoom, zoom indeed.
Zerline now for the PAT. He's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So that drive, 12 plays in length. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. Zerline out now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumbling.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Throw here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. He got 29 yards that time. They run the counter now on first down. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. The fly route works for the TD ground.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Butker on for the PAT. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. That time, 75-yard drive, five plays. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This one taken from the 7. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And the Rams getting set to go now. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
First down, he'll drop to throw it. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. The Rams on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
All right, here we go. Blue line. Blue line.
They'll set up a throw. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Now it's Zuerlein to try the Ram field goal. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they take a 17-14 lead. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
The made field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And the Rams got him. They bring him down.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Drop to throw. Looking deep downfield. That's caught inside the 20. A big play there for KC. 66 yards.
Today's receivers in the NFL, they're the complete package nowadays. We know they can run, we know they can catch, but they have those big frames now. So oftentimes they just out-physical guys downfield and go up and catch the football. And we saw a big gain as a result on that play.
Zone now. They'll look